each one with a different center, and each one creamier, sweeter, and more delicious than the one that came before. Why, I can make chewing gum that never loses its taste, or creamy caramels that change colors every 10 seconds as they dissolve delectably in your mouth. I've also created the biggest and best candy empire that the world has ever known. But I have no one to leave it to. No one to replace it. No one to make new candy dreams come true when I retire. And alas, the time for me to retire is already long overdue.
George, she did say hi. She said flavor shifter, my.
3,914.
Wow, that must be a world record.
Close. I love to hope.
Nobody can and toast.
Do you think one day I might be able to get a job for toothpaste factory?
Well, for your sake, I hope not, Charlie. Now, what kind of positive thinking is that? Charlie's going to work for Mr. Wonka, making chocolate bars.
Now, Brother Joe, don't be going to fill that boy's head with drinks and candy.
Randy! I got one!
Buddy, just a kid. Wow, didn't she give him Randy?
She said candy.
I know! She's got to give the kid some Randy!
Candy!
What?
Candy!
I'm right here. You don't have to yell. You got to remember that Charlie's descended from a long, distinguished line of chocolate men.
And women.
Yeah, but Wonka hasn't hired any ladies since Slumber Spies stole that candy balloon recipe. Wonka was so angry, he gathered all the workers together and said, I'm sorry, but you must all go home. Then he closed the gates of the factory forever.
But Mr. Wonka will make candy. I'm home on my way to school.
Yes, but no one goes in, and no one comes out.
That'll work first.
Maybe the undead. Who knows?
Grandpa Joe, you're going to give Charlie nightmares again.
Charlie wants to play again. We're playing Jim.
Run out to see if anybody's done with today's paper.
Okay, but you'll have to see Grandpa George.
All right, here you go, Pop. Here's your cat suit.
But I thought we were playing Jim.
You see these kids? They meet outside Charlie's house every day after lunch with a shiny little piece to buy a Wonka Pop from the local candy man. The only one with no name.
Come on, Charlie. Do you want some candy?
Not today. I'm on a special diet.
Looks like it's working. Let me pick something out. I got a nickel.
You already got a lollipop. Shouldn't you finish it first?
I can't help it. I just love candy. Chocolate, caramels, jawbreakers, suckers, anything.
Stop. It makes my mouth water.
I can't stop.
Thank you.
decided on 5 children to tour his world famous factory. The lucky 5 will get a tour of the factory and win a lifetime supply of chocolate.
For the factory?
A lifetime supply of chocolate?
Read on!
5 golden tickets have been hit. Among 59 ordinary candy bars.
That's a 59 to 1 shot. I don't like those odds.
The finders of the golden tickets will win the tour and the chocolate.
What are you all talking about?
Wonka's having a contest.
Why were you on a screen test?
A contest!
Who is it?
Wonka!
Well, what about him?
He's having a contest!
All right! Not dead, you know.
Those golden tickets can be anywhere. How exciting! I wonder if anyone has found them yet. That paper is a day old.
Charlie, can you imagine winning?
Touring the factory? Meeting Mr. Wonka?
Seeing all those undead zombie workers.
Eating a lifetime supply of chocolate.
Eating a lifetime supply of chocolate.
Oh, 1 o'clock already? Charlie, you better hurry or you're going to be late for school.
Well, it's back to twists and turns of toothpaste caps for me. Goodbye, Mrs. Bucket.
Goodbye, Mr. Bucket.
Hey, Charlie. Now, you gotta remember, Charlie, that we may be starving.
Starving?
We may be poor.
Poorer than church night.
The Bucket family always
thinks positive.
Charlie! Hey, Charlie!
Yes, Grandpa George?
Come here. Come over here.
Yes, Grandpa George, what is it?
Now, Charlie, we may be starving.
Yes, Grandpa George.
And we may be poor.
We already done that.
But the Bucket family
always thinks positive. I know, Grandpa George, I know.
Now, how did he know I was going to say that?
Now, write it down on purple ink, Charlie. If you write it in purple ink, you'll never forget.
Now, that's positive.
So Mr. Bucket was back up to the toothpaste factory, and little Charlie Bucket was on his way to school. But along the way, Charlie received some bad news.
Did you hear? Don't give them the first gold ticket!
Already? What?
Today! Look!
Eat more,
eat more,
eat more.
Good boy, good boy.
when should we put you in the school?
Training? Oh, yeah.
For the young to eat as much as Augustus, he must train from morning to night, eating all kinds of the foods. If this was the Olympics, Augustus could have the gold medal.
Nuts. and start selling wrappers. And how many wrappers did Veronica sell?
None, you pea-brain. Veronica doesn't do manual labor. We have people for that, and my father will have you fired for mispronouncing my name. Auntie Daddy.
Whatever you want, Pidgey. Whatever you want. Anyway, after days and days of shelling chocolates, one of my lucky factory girls finally found that lousy golden ticket. Be of a generous sort, I rewarded her and all. Sent that lucky piece of chocolate home to her and her 17 children. Just didn't feel right not to, you know what I mean?
How the wrong.
Daddy, now he's being sarcastic. I want to fire, you hear me?
We got! Don't forget the nuts!
Since you can't have chocolate without you nuts. Good luck, Veronica.
It's Veronica!
So after just one day, there are only three golden tickets remaining. Stay tuned for the continuous coverage of this extraordinary contest. Let's hope at least one golden ticket winner is deserving among the five. Tread out!
The candy shop. We want to be first in line. Come on.
That's okay. You want us, Abby. We'll see ya. I'm going to be the first in line.
Not if I can help it. Race you there.
No.
fresh cabin soon.
Now that I'm confident.
I
archivals all day long, except when I'm eating. Then I take some out of my mouth and put it behind my ear, like this.
She thought of that herself. She is so clever. So clever.
Mom, cool it! And then I sleep, I put the belt on my head. So in the morning, all I have to do is put it, pop it back into my mouth and start chewing it again.
She thought of that too. So clever.
Sometimes it's hard to get started. And one time it got stuck in my hair. But Mom cut it out and I was right on chewing it again. It was a hairy moment, though.
Isn't she just hilarious?
Very witty, Violet. And how about your ticket?
Okay, keep your pants on, Phineas. I'm getting to it. So, like I said, I'm a dungeon girl. But when I heard about Wonka's contest, I went off film and threw it straight on the paintbrush. That's how I found that ticket. Now, of course, I'm right back on the dungeon. In fact, I've been working on this here for 3 months solid. I beat the record set by my best friend, Cornelia. Hi, Cornelia, what's up next? That's the sound of you losing. Listen to more. She won that Princess Prince medal.
And this just in, a fourth bulletin ticket has been found in television city, California. Leaving only the fifth and final ticket to be found. We're live from the home of Mike TV, the lucky finder of golden ticket number 4. Here's Miss TV now. Tell us about the ticket.
Oh, well, you see, Mike and I were...
Cut the chit-chat, Mom. Didn't I tell you I never interrupt? This is the best part. Crap. Smack, whack, dead! Did you think I died? I'm so totally lost.
So we gather, Mike. Now we should be about to book a ticket.
Zip it! The next one just looks like one of dude.
Wait a minute. Here's the one. Talk to me? Hold on, get in the car. Talk to me?
Mike, would you mind telling us about the...
Dude, can't you see I'm busy running an empire here?
Gotta go. Catch you there.
Okay, Oprah, what do you want?
Mike, I'd like you to tell our audience how it feels to...
Check it out, I love this show! Wait a minute. You play me? I'm the best dude, the best.
You see, Mike has certain focus issues.
Big shiny titty dog. So what? Means you'd have half to be my favorite chosen to tour some stupid chocolate factory, which probably has crappy shows. Forgive me, Oprah, baby. That's a good chip. Dude, check her out.
Now, which school does our latest golden ticket winner attend?
School? Are you joking? They're just crazy. Who needs school? I got a net, TV, and game board. Cool.
Kids like to flex the trees. Some kids like to use their brains. Turn a university degree. I don't share that thirst for knowledge. I ain't gonna go to college. Gee, I see it all on TV. Some kids like to
grass.
What'd she say? What'd she say?
She says she spotted grass.
Catch one. Maybe we need it.
That's quite enough. Time for bed.
Hey, Grandma, do you have to tell me one more orange story? Just one, please.
All right, just one. But no zombie worker stories. Charlie needs his rest.
You guys care if Pop tells Charlie a bedtime story? I guess not. I'll help you clean up, Mrs. Bucket.
So, Charlie, have I got a story for you?
What's it about? A giant peach? Pirates? Zombies?
Oh, I promise your mom, no zombie stories. No, this story's about a little boy. It just so happened to be this little boy's birthday.
Yeah?
This little boy thought he'd open all his presents. But guess what? There was one for him. Look here, Charlie.
A Wonka that crashed the price!
Oh, I have my list. Now remember, Charlie, you're still a teeny tiny, 1,000,000 to 1 chance. This here bar is still hiding.
That's
it. What's going on over here?
Hey, Pop, what's that in your hand? Just a little something for me to Charlie on his birthday. Now, shh, quiet. I don't want to wake the others.
What's going on?
I don't know, Pop,
what? What do we got there, Bill?
This is between me and the boy. Now, go on, Charlie. Go
on. I can't. I'm too nervous. You open it, Grandpa Joe.
I tell you what. Let's do it together. A lifetime supply of chocolate. 3, 2, 1.
Nothing.
Good thing, really. Chocolate. Very fancy.
You're right. A lifetime supply of it. Why, you'd be the size of an adult on Capitol Hill.
I wish I never heard of candy or Wonka.
Oh. I'm thinking of that. Cheer up, Charlie. Give me a smile. What happened to that smile I used to know? Don't you know your grin has always been my sunshine?
Blue sky. Then the wind. Jets of freezing cold air came rushing in through the sides of the windows and under the doors, and there was no place to escape them. The four old folks lay silent, huddled in their beds, trying to keep the cold out of their bones. For the Bucket family, the excitement of the golden tickets was long forgotten. In fact, all they could think about was trying to scrape together enough food and stay warm through another long, cold day as winter tightened its grip. Mr. Bucket searched for odd jobs, like shoveling snow. Little Charlie Bucket began the long uphill trek towards school.
Take a little taste, you know, just to make sure you like it too.